is listening, Father. Good morning, you wonderful people. So today I want to share another short testimony on the goodness of God. This one is maybe a little bit more controversial than some of the others, but I'd like to invite you to just listen and ask God if this makes any sense, if this is truly a revelation of who He is. I love the Psalms, I love the scripture. And one of the things I love doing more than anything else in my meditational time with the Father is to actually take the Psalms, the scriptures, and what I do, I actually read the scriptures and I try to imagine what David was going through, what was the emotional state he was in when he was writing those scriptures. I mean, I can never get it right, but I was at least trying to live into that scripture, meditating a scripture and chewing it and making my own. I was busy with Psalm 139 here at home. My family was away for the weekend. And I was just really, really just pressing into the Father, into His goodness. And I became so aware that His faithfulness is bigger than what I'll ever understand. As far as the east is from the west. Sure, His faithfulness is good. Even if I run to where the sun sets or to where the sun comes up, He's there. If I go up to heaven or to the hell, He's there. But then what happened to me was something unique. When I got to Psalm 139 verse 11, it says, "Even if I ask the darkness to hide me, even there you will be, because the darkness is as light to you." I read in a little bit of a different section. It says, "If I were to say the darkness must hide me." I was quite confused at this. I was saying, what has to happen for David to ask the darkness to hide him from God? That's quite a drastic statement. And no matter what I tried, I could not imagine what that meant. I would have no idea what that meant. And then just like that, I had an out-of-body experience and I was sitting in the second heaven. And I was sitting in front of a massive dark black rock altar. And I see in my hands that I've got a big blade, and I actually take my arms and I start cutting my arms open and I pour my blood over this altar and I'm crying and I call out and I ask all of the demonics, all the names of the demonic I know, and I'm crying out to the demonic to come and hide me from God. And I can see in the distance their eyes looking at me, but they're keeping far away from me, hey? And the more I cry out, the further they stay away from me. And then I get a revelation, I hear a voice just behind me, and it's my Father. He's standing there, tapping his toe, looking at me and saying, "Erich, is that the best you can do? Sorry, but you're going to have to up your game. You're going to have to seriously up your game, because I will not leave you. I will not forsake you. My Son paid for you with His blood. You are way too precious to me for me to ever abandon you or forsake you. You are mine. And even here in this darkness, it is as light to me. You're going to have to up your game, my son, because I will not leave you. I will not forsake you." I'm out of my body again. I realize what the heck is happening. I open up my eyes and there I'm sitting in my lounge again on my carpet with a Bible in front of me. My friends, I had a one-on-one encounter with the living God in the pits of hell while I was trying to offer myself unto the enemy to hide me from the goodness of God. And God mocked me in love, saying to me, "I'm going to have to up my game. I'm going to have to do way worse than this than I can ever imagine for Him to even imagine leaving me." The goodness of God led me to repentance that I've never experienced in my life. I stood up from the floor there weeping, not because of what I did, but because of who He is. Every single spirit of performance, of spiritual performance, lifted off of me. every single piece of self-judgment which I had inside of me, which I thought I'd approve myself to God. I'm not allowed to do this. I must do this. I've got my to-do list and my don't do this list. And it's as if he just took every single burden I've ever carried and lifted it off of me and replaced it with a faithfulness, not in myself, not in my ability, but in the faithfulness of who he is as a good father. Even the darkness is as light to him. What will the enemy do? What will I do? What will the enemy do to separate me from the love of God? Nothing I do. I am not strong enough. I am not able to separate myself from the love of God. How much less the enemy? It's the goodness of God which leads us to repentance. Not because what I do or I do not do. He is good. He is so good. He will never leave you nor forsake you. See him. Look at him. Raise up your eyes and see him looking at you. Open your ears and listen to what he's saying to you. And only do what you see him do. And only say what you hear him say. I love you guys. And I bless you in Jesus' name.